learningspace.com.ng.
Hello Ade, welcome to the last segment, the last series of lectures for Varieties of Organisms, series 17 for Varieties of Organisms. I am very sure that so far so good, you've enjoyed the previous lectures we've had so far. So we'll go straight now to the first question for this last series. And the question was extracted from the West Africa Examination School Certificate past question 2009 number one, and the question reads: a group of closely related organisms capable of interbreeding to produce fertile offsprings are known as, I explained this earlier on, the answer is species. That is a group of organisms that can freely interbreed to produce fertile offspring. That's the best definition for a species. So our answer is option D. Now the next question, extracted from the WAEC past question 2009 number three, now it reads: a beaker of pond water containing few specimens of Euglena was placed in a dark room for 2 weeks. At the end of this experiment, the specimens of Euglena were still alive because they were, of course, the answer here is option A, they were able to carry out holozoic nutrition. Now look at the basics behind the question. Now the Euglena cell is the Euglena is an organism that exhibits features of both plants and animals. There are two basic organisms in this category, Euglena and Chlamydomonas. They have plant features and they also have animal features. Okay, now one plant feature possessed by Euglena is the possession of chloroplast, which enables it to feed photosynthetically to manufacture food for itself. Now the question said that the Euglena cell was placed in a dark room for 2 weeks and was still found to be alive. In other words, for 2 weeks being inside the dark room, it was not photosynthesizing. Now since it was not photosynthesizing, then it means it will have to switch over to the other mode of nutrition, that's the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, which is the holozoic type, that's feeding like an animal cell. So the reason it was still alive was because it carried out holozoic nutrition. That's option A. Now the next question, extracted also from the WAEC pack 2009 number 8, it reads: red blood cells were found to have burst. Red blood cells were found to have burst open after being placed in distilled water for an hour. This phenomenon is known as, of course, the answer is hemolysis. We call it hemolysis. Of course, the word hem, once you come across this word, what comes to your mind is blood, the red blood cells. Okay, lysis means splitting, breakage, bursting. So when you place the red blood cells in a hypotonic solution, that's a solution with a very low concentration of salt, it absorbs water and it bursts. Now the opposite of this is a term called crenation, which means shrinkage of the red blood cells, this time when placed in a hypertonic solution. So the shrinkage of the red blood cell in a hypertonic solution is called crenation. It's called crenation. Okay, now in humans, the excessive use of a group of drugs called laxatives is known to be a major cause of crenation. Okay, laxatives are artificial drugs that can chemically stimulate digestion, that can aid digestion artificially or chemically. For example, there's this drug, this solution of magnesium sulfate, commonly called Andrews. It's a solution of magnesium sulfate. It's a common laxative, and an excessive intake of laxatives can result to crenation, which is the shrinkage of the red blood cells. Okay, now the next question, it reads: which of the following represents the correct sequence from the most simple to the most complex of organizations? Now again, this question is based on the topic levels of organization, that's organization of life. Now don't forget what I said then. I said the smallest level of life is a cell. A cell contains organelle. So our answer here is option B. The first structure there is an organelle, which is mitochondrion. The neuron is a cell. The muscle is a tissue. The heart is an organ. The alimentary canal is a system, and the rabbit is an organism. So it falls in place with exactly what we discussed then, when I said organelles make up cells, cells make up tissues, tissues make up organs, organs make up systems, systems make up organisms. So our answer here is option B, mitochondrion, an organelle, neuron, a cell, muscle, a tissue, heart, an organ, alimentary canal, a system, rabbit, an organism. So our answer is option B. thank you very much for watching, and I know you had a nice time listening to our lectures on varieties of living organisms, and I'm very sure that after listening to this particular series of lectures, you have no fear preparing for your biology exams with regards varieties of living organisms. And don't forget, in Learning Space, we've put in place so many things that will drive you towards making a good result, an excellent result in your JAM, in your WAEC, and your NECO examinations. Now, one of them is the fact that we've been able to put in place a textbook known as Explicit Biology. Now, Explicit Biology is a textbook that has been well recommended by authorities in biology, especially for students preparing for JAM, NECO, and WAEC. And I'm very, very sure that there is no way you make use of this biology for preparation for your exams and you regret you did. Definitely you won't. So I'm highly recommending this book, Explicit Biology, a product of learningspace.com.ng, for every student writing biology either in JAM, in WAEC, or in NECO, or even sitting for any biology exams, be it within or outside Nigeria. The book would definitely be of an immense use for such students. And I also want to use this medium also to let you know that Learning Space is open to criticism, is open to comments, is open to advice. So you always feel free to drop your comments and just call the numbers on your screen for any academic advice, educational advice, and anywhere you feel we might be of help to you in terms of achieving 100% success in your examinations. And also, if you feel you need a personal contact with any staff of learningspace.com.ng, you just need a one-on-one contact, feel free to call the numbers that will appear on your screen. And also, don't forget to follow us on Facebook. On Facebook is learningspace.com.ng. You can go on your website, you Google it, you get it, www.learningspace.com.ng. For every inquiry, every academic assistance, every educational advice towards you achieving 100% success in your examinations, please don't forget, the only site to visit and the only place to be logged on 24 hours of the day is learningspace.com.ng. I still remain your anchorman, Amos by name, your anchorman for biology and chemistry. Until we meet in the next lecture, I say I'm signing out right now.